Hi everyone and thanks for clicking my video. This week's video I might need to start with once upon a time, because this data file already stored in my computer for a very long time and maybe already has a layer of dust onto it. Actually, this was one of the very first videos that I have filmed when I started the entire YouTube thing, which was back in May 2017, so this year, so depending on what year you watched this video. I did store it ever since because I was not really sure if I liked the result and if I want to show it to the public, but just recently I thought, well, although I feel like failing in this one, probably someone else is going to learn something from it, and I can tell what I do differently these days after having some more experience, and probably, yeah, I can help someone out with some issues they face themselves. If you know my channel, and I think I tell this in every video, I was, or more or less am, a realist painter and drawer. And just recently this year I came across the entire acrylic pouring idea and concept, and I think it was when I watched one of Lisa's from Lucky Fine Art channel's videos, where she made this acrylic pour and painted something over it. I really liked the concept and found it interesting, and I've never heard anything about acrylic pouring before that. And it didn't even occur to me trying something like this, because I normally did not use acrylic paint that often. I did use acrylic paint when I was starting with my entire arts career and used it for painting, as you know, you do with acrylic paints. But I never really was so amazed by them, because they tried that quickly and I wasn't able to blend them quite smoothly, and I had no ideas and there was no guidance and the internet was still in baby shoes, so I really did not like them that much. I already had oil colors stored in my art equipment, but was afraid to use them because, you know, oil colors are for the old masters and only experienced artists, and I never saw myself as an experienced artist and therefore was horrified using them, and I stored them about 4 years in my equipment until I caught myself over it and tried them, and ever since I fell in love with the oil paints, which you can see in other videos as well here on my channel. Coming back to this project, I watched a video from Lisa and wanted to try it myself, because I need to try everything new when I see something, you know. Do you know that feeling when you see something new on another channel or artist and you instantly need to have this yourself? Although you have no equipment at all to try this, you need to have it, you need to try it and instantly buy everything you need. I'm such a person, which is hard at times. Nevertheless, I had some acrylic paint still left in my art equipment from ages ago and when I do underpaintings and stuff, but not anything special actually. So I just went for the Liquitex pouring medium, which Lisa was actually showing in her video, and as I had no idea what stuff is around in the world out there, I just ordered this one because she showed it and I thought it was the only thing that works for it. So I got it myself and used some acrylic paints that I had available, which you can see here in the video. Fun fact, when you see the end result in the very end, you will see almost none of the colors that you can see here, which is still a bit amazing. But I wanted to tell you what actually I made and what did not work for me. So I mixed my paints using the Liquitex pouring medium and my acrylic paints, and I thought that was it. So just the paint, the pouring medium, stir it around and fine. What you cannot see here in the video, I also used some silicone because I was at a point that I already knew that I have to use it to make the cell creation happen. And I did not have the silicone that I'm using now, which is the Dimethicone. I just used some silicone that I had available at this time. And this was more or less a small spray bottle with a spray silicone in it. And this was used to fix your bicycles and to, but more or less just a small spray bottle with the silicone that was needed to, yeah, care for bicycles. So it was really, really smelly, so I had to spray it in the paint outside of my flat, and it only went away when the paint was dry, so I really did not use it ever again. So when my paint was mixed, I went on to create the dirty cup. And at this point I had no idea about consistency and whatsoever. I just used the paint whatever consistency it had, because it was just paint which was thinner than from the tube and it was runny, and I thought this will be all okay and fine and perfect to work. And I had tried some other projects before with just blue and green and red color palettes, so each color is separate basically, and I was amazed how good it works and the paint was flowing and I had some cells created and it was perfectly pretty for me. Watching it now, it totally failed. there was no definition, and it was just runny, and the cells were not really cells. It was more like blobs of paint. I really did not like the effect that it created overall. I will see if I still have some photos of it left, and I can make some photos here in this video to show you how they looked. Compared to the stuff that I'm now doing, completely different and less advanced, of course, as it was the very beginning. So I made my dirty cup here and put all the colors that I have in it. And seeing it now, I can see that the paint is way too runny, way too thin. And when your paint is way too thin, you will achieve the effect that I'm going to achieve here in this project. Meaning there is no really cell definition, the paint is too runny, you will not have any clear colors in the end. So in the end, everything will be a bit smushed up and not as defined as you probably wanted to have. So basically only one project of these four pours that you can see here in this video I really like. But back then I loved every one of them, because it was color, it was poured, it was pretty, and it was the best I can come up with. Having poured all the colors into my cup and flipped it or poured it onto the canvases, I was amazed that all the colors turned into green, and I had no green put into it in the first place. So having two runny colors, you will make them intermix way, way more than your colors would if you had made them thicker. And just now I used a consistency like honey, and it helped this in all videos. So if you mix your paint and you pick up your stick from the paint, it should make an even flow stream towards the paint. So no dripping, no blobbing the paint, it should make an even stream flowing from the stick to the paint. Then your color is more or less the right consistency. So like honey from these squeeze bottles or so. Another challenge that you're going to face when your paint is too runny is basically that when you tilt your canvas, the paint will run off quite quickly and you will not be able to maintain certain areas that you think you might want to keep because they look pretty or because there is some cells happening that you want to keep. This is a bit more difficult because as soon as you tilt, everything will run towards the direction that you're tilting and just tearing everything apart that you had on the canvas and create its new shape in a way. You can see this happen here in my attempt as well. So if you're new to acrylic pouring and have not done so many projects yet, make sure that your paint has more or less the right consistency. So not too thick, not too thin, like honey. And the only project that I actually really liked from the entire design and look was from the second pouring and the right pour with the blue ribbon going through the entire project. This one I really liked. I will show you some pictures in the end from the dried projects, which dried a bit darker and so it looked in a way a bit better than it when it was wet. But the other three projects, they are in a way cute, but not really overwhelming. But overall, I need to say that I did not order any of the Liquitex pouring medium ever again, because it just felt like making the paint too runny and not as, I don't know. I was really not able to create such super pretty effects that I am able to achieve now when I use the float roll or the acrylic binder or just the acrylic paint on its own. So I don't know what it was, if I used too much of the pour medium, but if I had used less, then I don't know. So this was just my experience. If you asked me what to use, I would recommend the float roll, because this works really awesome. It is quite pricey. So here in Germany, 2.5 liters are about 40 euros, plus minus, it differs from day to day, which is not that cheap. The acrylic binder is in the same price range, I think. It's still a bit cheaper than just using the paint without any medium and thinning it down with water. So whatever you actually prefer the most. But in terms of medium, the float roll works the very best for me. And I think for now I'm going to stay there. For those of you who do not know her, but I think you will when you do acrylic pours, I watch Annemarie Ritterhoff and her channel. She is explaining everything perfectly. She has a ton of videos and she's that artist who experiments, I think, the very most from all the channels that I have seen. And once a new medium is coming out, she will be among the first to know and to share it with all of us. So have a look at her channel as well. And if something new comes up, I will for sure test it as well and show you. And I hope you liked this video as well, although it was really old footage from my very first pouring attempts that I did. But as I do not use green that often, you probably liked that there was something green in this video, although I did not use any green in the first place. Anyways, I hope you liked it. Please leave a comment below if you have any questions or additions to this video. If you're new to my channel and liked what I did, please subscribe and have a look at my other videos. And again, thank you for watching and I wish you a great day. Bye bye.